With an empty judge's chair in the beginning of season 9, off we go with the additions, and one in particular stood out from the rest. Not because of the fact that he was disqualified because of his age, but because of the song and dance he provided. Enter General Larry Platt with his song, Pants on the Ground.
Oh, you're a general. Okay, 3.
Pants on the ground, pants on the ground. Looking like a fool with your pants on the ground. With the gold in your mouth, hat turned sideways, pan hit the ground. Call yourself a cool cat, looking like a fool. Walking downtown with your pants on the ground. Giddy up. Hey, get your pants off the ground. Looking like a fool, walking, talking with your pants on the ground. Giddy up. Yeah. Hey, get your pants off the ground. Looking like a fool with your pants on the ground. Go in the mouth.
Okay.
Head turns
okay.
Up. Hey, hit the ground. Call yourself
thank
a cool
you.
Cat. Looking like a fool. Walking, talking with your pants on the ground. Boom.
Whoa,
pants on the ground.
Whoa.
Looking like a fool. Ground with the gold in your mouth. Head turn sideways. Pair hit the ground.
Larry.
Call yourself
Larry.
A cool kid.
Thank you. Larry, what was that song called?
Thank you. Pants on the ground.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Positive?
Thank you.
You know, I have a horrible feeling that song could be a hit.
I'm very sure his heart was in the right place, but being that the song was showing awareness, however, even with the day age disregarded, I'm pretty sure there's no way that song would have went on to the next round. Well, with season 9 underway and Hollywood Week approaching, the producers was wondering, who are we going to fill out the fourth judge's chair up with? Enter Ellen DeGeneres.
Martha, one question.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You know how you invited the principal to dinner?
Yeah.
Why? Oh, aquí vamos otra vez. Here it goes.
A lot of AI fans wasn't down with Ellen judging because they felt like she didn't know anything about judging a person singing. That's a maybe, but not singing. Now, usually in the semifinals, the girls go first singing, then the guys. However, one of the girls had type 1 diabetes and fell ill to a diabetic ketoacidosis. So, they reversed it to the boys going first, then the girls. One of the producers wanted to disqualify her, but that did not take place. Thank God. Now the judges' save prevailed again. This time for finalist Michael Lynch, being that he had the lowest votes at the end of the top 9 show. However, it was double elimination for finalists Katie Stevens and Andrew Garcia the following week.
He came to us months ago. He became a father in the process. His wife, his little girl, wanting to know what happens in their future, and it's in the judges' hands. Remember, one save, there's just one save per season. It's only valid until we get to the top 5. Now, guys in the studio, bring it down. Let's bring it down for a second. What happens with Michael's future? Are you going to use the save? Simon?
Well, the frustrating thing is, Michael, is that we all wish you did something like that yesterday. And this is why you're in the position you're in right now, because of what happened yesterday. We only have one save in the competition.
That's right.
This is unanimous, Michael, if there's any comfort. And we have decided we're going to see you next week.
On April 21st, 2010, Idol Gives Back returned for the final time, but did raise $45 million. Now, this was a trying time for Idol because the judges' panel was undergoing surgery. Not only Cara DeGuardi and Ellen DeGeneres will be leaving the show this season, but the very lovable Simon Cowell will be leaving the show as well. He will go on to focus on getting the X Factor launch here in the United States. With that said, there was a special tribute dedicated to Cowell, and Paula Abdul will make a special guest appearance wishing him well.
Sharing our lives, we made it through the good and bad times.
And here we stand with hope in our hearts.
Together we will do our part. And now we've come so far. To touch a star, go higher and higher.
Find your guiding inspiration in a place where dreams are made.
With a lifetime preparation, it's no time to be afraid.
Put our differences behind us while we shine like the sun.
What we've all become, together we are one.
Together we are one. We are
one. Find your guiding inspiration in a place where dreams are made.
Wonderful, guys. Wonderful. Simon, come up here for a second. Come on. Come on, judges. Push them up here. You know, I didn't think I was going to be this emotional, but I genuinely am. I just want to say it's great to have this little one back. But you know what Paula said is true. You know, the show goes forward, it will be different. But I just want to thank you from the bottom of my heart for the support, the fun. And everyone... your sense of humor. I mean, that's what's been the best part. Seeing these contestants back, that's what's made the show. And you know what the truth is? When everyone asks who's going to replace me, who's going to be the next judge, the truth is, You guys are the judge of this show, and you've done an incredible job over the years. And even you, I'm going to honestly, honestly miss you. And I want to thank everybody. I'm not going to name names, but the production team, the people who put all this together, thank you very much indeed. It's been a blast. Thank you.
With this being Simon's final show, he gets to see the final idol crowned. The two finalists that are going for it all were Lee DeWise and Barrel Socks. Whom won the title?
I can now tell you. The winner of American Idol 2010 is... Lee DeWise!
Looking in total shock, Lee DeWise took the title for season 9. However, this season, neither contestant used a new song for an induction song. Oh no. Instead, DeWise chose U2's song, Beautiful Day, as the induction.
Here it is. Lee DeWise, your new idol, Beautiful Day. Good night, everybody.
She's up through the stony ground. There is no room. No space to rent in this town. You're out of luck. And the reason that she had to care, the traffic is stuck.
This is the first season where neither finalist got a lot of album sales. What a pity, because both contestants were A1 to me, in my opinion. With this said, it's time to fill up some judges' seats.